Welcome to the Defense and Aerospace Report. I'm Vagha Maradian here at the Air Force Association's annual Airspace Cyber Conference and Trade Show, the number one gathering of U.S. Air Force leaders from around the world, here outside the nation's capital on the 72nd birthday of the United States Air Force. Our coverage here is sponsored by L3 Harris and Leonardo DRS, and we're here at the Raytheon stand to talk to retired United States Air Force Colonel Mark Noyes. Sir, how are you? Excellent call sign. I can't imagine N-O-Y-E-S why anybody would have given you that call sign. And you're the executive for business development here at Missiles and former illustrious helicopter pilot, I should add to our audience. So talk to us a little bit about Peregrine, a new weapon system at a time when the United States Air Force is looking to extend reach, extend range, whether for defense or for offense. You guys have a couple of things in the portfolio. Talk to us about the Peregrine missile, because it bears a startling resemblance in some cases to, I don't know, maybe a standard missile a little bit in terms of genetics.
Well, all I can say is the Peregrine missile is a new platform that complements our air dominance franchise and our air dominance portfolio of weapons. That franchise, as you know, is made up of our medium-range missile, the AMRAAM, and it also is made up of our 9X Sidewinder for short-range and very maneuverable type of dogfight missile. The beauty of Peregrine is we've taken and combined technologies from both AMRAAM, so that autonomous track and search, as well as the maneuverability of 9X, and we poured it into the Peregrine. And so we're really excited about its development.
Are you, and I also should have said AMRAAM, right? I mean, it looked a little standardish to me, but it also looks AMRAAM-ish as well. Are you comfortable talking a little bit about the range and some of the other performance characteristics of the weapon? Because, you know, there were those who look, for example, to the European Meteor in terms of being beyond visual range, kind of a good IFF, longer range weapon. Tell us a little bit about the parameter that you guys are working on.
So what we've done with Peregrine is it will cover both the short range, the within visual range fight, as well as the beyond visual range, medium range, that's associated with an AMRAAM missile. So you really do get a nice hybrid missile that complements AMRAAM and 9X in the air dominance role. It also goes supersonic, so the time of flight to the enemy or the target of, or your intended target, is very, very reduced. So the beauty of that is, once you get rid of one target, you're immediately on to another, and you really create a lot of chaos, and you get inside the enemy's OODA loop, and next thing you know, you maintain air dominance as the mission proceeds.
We've got the inventory in part because of the inventory we have, right? Sidewinder was in the inventory. It's been the short range, the infrared weapon for a very, very long time. And then we've worked to longer range radar-guided weapons when you get out in range. Certainly having one weapon that does both streamlines supportability, streamlines, but then there's always a cost sensitivity, right? The Air Force is like that shorter range weapon that's a little bit less expensive, and I keep my AMRAAMs for longer range. How do you get that price point? Because, you know, we just heard from Defense Secretary Esper, you know, hey, we've got to be very, very thoughtful about how we spend stuff, what we bring into the inventory. He's also looking at sustainability support, logistics trains. What's the value proposition you're making to the Air Force at a time when every penny is precious?
I'm glad you raised that point. The beauty of Peregrine is we're taking existing technologies, military off-the-shelf technologies. We're also using additive manufacturing processes that are resident in Raytheon missile systems, and we're pouring those into Peregrine. What that does is it gives us a lower risk missile for development. We can produce it at a far lower cost, and we pass those cost savings on to the warfighter. The beauty is also that they can get more missiles on their fourth and fifth generation fighters. And of course, I don't have to tell you, to have full magazines where you're not going Winchester quite as soon keeps the enemy off balance and keeps us on the aggressive side of the offense.
Let's go to the Joint Strike Missile. Obviously, a great partnership you guys have with Norway's Kongsberg. Naval Strike Missile was a big win for you guys. Even if some of the competitive dynamic was a little bit different at the time of award on that. Talk to us a little bit about the capability, its jam resistance, and other attributes that you guys feel is the right choice.
Well, the beauty of the JSM, the Joint Strike Missile, is it really is leveraging all the goodness that we got off of our Naval Strike Missile. Kongsberg is a wonderful teammate of ours. We're working together to develop and produce a missile that's going to be affordable to the warfighter. It's going to be just the premier OASUW missile. It'll fit in the bay of an F-35. Extremely survivable. The end game of this missile is unbelievable. And its ability to do low-level operations. I'm talking super sea skimming operations across the ocean to avoid enemy radars and get in close before they even know what's going on. And also, you can launch these simultaneously, so we have simultaneous arrival of missiles at either one ship or a variety of ships. You maintain the element of surprise, and before the enemy knows it, it's over.
And affordability is something that has been designed into the system.
Absolutely. We're using, again, established manufacturing processes, military off-the-shelf technology, and the leverage that we enjoy from the Naval Strike Missile to pass those savings on to not only the domestic warfighter here in the United States, but also our international partners.
So what do you see as, you know, obviously a big domestic market for these, but also you guys project a significant international market. Do you want to put some numbers around each one of these in terms of what global market size would be that you guys are pursuing?
I won't put the numbers around them, but I will tell you they're both built for exportability. And the beauty of that is that's in keeping with the national defense strategy of the United States that says, hey, we want to strengthen our coalition partners and attract new partners. And both these missiles are built for exportability, and we see them as being a vital element of any international partner's portfolio.
Retired United States Air Force Colonel Mark Maybe Noyes, who is the Business Development Executive here at Raytheon Missiles. Sir, thanks very, very much. Best of luck with both programs, and certainly looking forward to the system. So have you managed to, you know, Raytheon has a reputation of actually not doing a lot of slide decks. You guys have done some development and testing work on this before you brought it to market, which would be my expectation.
Yep, you got it. And we're working with our customers to make sure that we're filling any gaps that they think this thing has, and we're pretty excited about it.
Very good. Thanks again, sir.
Thank you.